Well, it's day two for these guys here in New Mexico. Day one for me, getting here to film them. They've got some really great bulls, and I think we're gonna get some action today. You getting your spotter rigged up?
Oh man, so you can see them real close.
You went ahead and got the tripod, didn't you?
Oh, you know it, dude. Gear nut. Still haven't worked the tripod yet. That's where it all starts, right there. That's how bulls are killed.
Good to go?
It's gonna be a good day.
Good day, Tater.
Oh, big bull at the water tower. He's at, yeah, I don't know.
At the water tower. Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's gotta be.
I can see stickers.
There's a bunch of elk at the water tower and to the right of that water tower. There's a big bull at the tower right now.
Do you think we're hearing it that far away?
No, but they're coming this way, so we need to get where we were at, because last day we were late. Because we watched him too long, and then by the time we got there, he wanted to go do his thing.
Cut down through here and get your back? Just like we were yesterday?
I think we should go through that way, because it gets funky down here.
Yeah.
I'm going to do rock climbing today. A little different than OTC Colorado, huh?
Yeah.
There's up. Let's go. Let's get to that group of trees right there. You see him?
By that tree, he was 57 yards. Behind us. We got him behind us. That's gonna make perfect.
That's a good bull behind us too. Close side.
Tree right there was 57. He was about 10 yards to the left of it.
God.
That one is literally.
Do you see him?
No, but I mean, he was right down in that draw. He sounded like it.
The weatherman said it was going to be south wind, so we set up everything to be south blade. And we've got northeast, and we did everything we could to get skirted by this thing, and it just, we came up about a 45 degree angle short. That was a stud bull. There's a lot of other elk around.
Oh my God!
After looking at the footage, Jimmy hit pretty high. I mean, no need to even go look for the animal. Hit him above the spine, and his arrow might have just went off of him. I never saw his arrow. I was trying to move a little bit more because I knew he was about to shoot, and right when I did, he shot, but in slow motion, there's just a little dot up top. Not even any blood, just, I think his arrow took off like 150 yards in the air. Yeah, Colter's morning, the bull that Jimmy and I were on that winded us, Colter caught back up with him about 45 minutes later. Colter's arrow hit a limb and basically hit him back, gut shot. Possible liver, but I guess it depends on the height. The liver kind of runs up. So I don't know if he got it high or center mass. I don't know, I wasn't with him, I was with Jimmy. But this bull we were just working. I mean, had him come in, just, he was coming right at me so much that I was trying to film through the tree. But, not terrific news out here on the Elk Plains, but it's not for Jimmy. Poor guy. He's pretty upset for good reason. It's a 7x8, just absolute stud. I'll let you know what we do next. The Rio Grande to get to him.
Sad.
that cedar
I thought you were looking back at me and like you couldn't see, and I was like, he's right there.
No,
he's
we could see him on the other side of the cedar, but we didn't know. Like, we couldn't go around it.
Yeah, I stood and I ranged him, and he was at 33 yards from y'all at.
That tree we were in was thin. I mean, you could see him plain as day.
That's why I was like, man, go around. I was trying to, like, go around the back, go on the back. And I guess you couldn't
do it. Well, as soon as he turned, we did.
We moved. But then by the time I got over there, he was 66 yards and walked into this tree.
Dang.
By the time I dialed it.
Well, he was holding up until he saw those other bulls come over there, and then he got upset.
Yeah.
And he was at, like, 75, and we still couldn't, I mean.
That's okay. I just thought y'all couldn't see him, and I was like, what the hell?
No, we knew he was right there. Like I said, I could see the end of his nose.
That's what I was thinking. I was like, can y'all not hear him bugle? Oh, I'm pretty sure he can smell his breath.
You did an excellent job back there.
You did.
It sounded great.
Dang it.
They all liked it, that's for damn sure.
Yeah.
None of this is going on, so
try again tomorrow.
That was fun. Well, we've switched gears now. We're going to look for Colter's bull that he shot in the flank. Going to look for Colter's bull now, which he made a marginal shot on. I saw a spike walking over here, and he just like hit something in the wind and just hung up. Started acting real skittish, so. Also, there's been like 15 ravens going up and down right there, so I'm thinking we're gonna get over here and find Colter's bull from yesterday. We gave him all day yesterday. Colter shot him a little bit back. Now we're gonna go find him. He's a nice bull too. He is that original bull that Jimmy and I had at like 57 yards that winded us. As you probably saw earlier in the video. Colter shot him about 45 minutes later, a little bit further back. Anyhow, that's what we're doing now.
It's him. We found him. We found him. Oh my God. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Oh. Oh.
Knew it.
Holy cow. Holy cow. Why are you on the phone?
Well.
Jimbo.
This is awesome, dude.
I'm sorry, it wasn't you, man, but we'll... Oh my gosh.
He did, y'all were right, he did have that broken eye glass.
Me, thanks.
Dude.
Man.
Dude, that sucker has got some mass. Those royals are insane.
I'll send you this text. Picture.
That's a good bull, man.
You guys want me to tell you the story? So there it was. It all started when?
Let's do
this.
I
am filming, so go ahead.
5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 7
by 7.
God, that makes you feel so much better.
Look who that is, bro.
Huh?
Look who that is.
I'll be damned. Is it?
KG3 himself.
Is that him?
That's him. 100%. Come back here and look at it. 100%.
Oh, hey, no doubt.
That's her.
So no Ellis is actually KG3.
KG3, crowned out. We got 3 years. We got 3 years of history with that bull. I told you there was a picture in there that I could see that was offset.
That was him.
That was him. 100%.
Let me show the camera that.
Oh man, I'm blazing.
Yeah.
Oh, there he is. King George III.
I cannot believe we found him.
He's a good one.
Man.
So off the history, dude. So awesome. We watched that bull 3 years ago on the north side.
We got one picture of him.
Yeah, he was on that ridge, remember, with all them cows. Bedded down when we were out here scouting that day.
One photo, and then found him.
How's it feel?
Man, I'm telling you. Freaking legend of a bull. Check out his cap from the top. How crooked it is. Should be like back here. That's how we know it's KG3.
Yeah. I forgot about that.
Yeah, that's how you know it's him.
I'll be dang.
There's no denying that.
I forgot all about that.
3 years of footage of this guy. We saw him once last year on the hoof. Finally, we got an arrow in him in the third year.
You want to skin his head out while we're doing this?
Nah, I'll do it when we get home. I gotta get a screwdriver and get his cap off. It's awesome. Good out, fellas. We need one more. One more.
The ring of it. It's like in that middle saddle.
Oh, okay.
Right in front of that little teddy plateau that we set on before. Yeah. Real steep. You walk right in front of it and then it's kind of awesome. How are we going to go?
You're like fancy inside.
Let's go back here.